Just a few weeks ago, I came across something on the popular page of Roblox that shouldn't have been there. It was a game, to say the least. Not one of those bot-infested free Robux bandwagons. The game has since been taken down, but I will still try to write down everything I can remember happening on there before its removal. I was on the edge of the school year, ready to accomplish all the fun things summer break had in store for me. One of those many things was video games. I know, just another stereotypical teenager. My mother, of course, didn't want me associating with any electronics, so she planned on taking my Xbox 360 and other phone-filled devices for the time being. She left my phone, however, as I had friends I would go out with a lot, and she would call me every once in a while, make sure things were okay. Not that there was anything truly magnificent on there, anyways. Aside from all the useful apps I didn't plan to make use of, there was one I never considered purchasing in place of my console games, until the start of summer break. That game was Roblox. My friends laughed at the idea, but upon looking at it, it seemed to offer a lot for being free to play. Plus, I didn't have any money, so Minecraft and GTA San Andreas were out of the question. And those were my favorites. So, as I was seeking refuge under the roof from a blazing hot Saturday, I installed it. I was actually thrilled, to be honest. Unlike my friends who always thought games under the rating teen adolescent were babyish, I really liked the idea of an online game that allowed users from around the world to create practically anything they could imagine. Though it did require some skill. But I wasn't there to develop anything, I was there to have a great time. And before long, I made an account. At the time I had a guest account, which means I couldn't conserve with any players or try on cool accessories. I didn't mind, I could always make an account, if I wanted to. But I was just trying out the game and thought about deleting it later on. But I didn't. As summer break traveled along, I found myself playing it more and more. I made a large amount of progress on games like Jailbreak and Bee Swarm Simulator, which I was fairly good at. If I do say so myself. I even convinced a few of my friends to hop on, and we had a great time. But all that fun didn't last long. As the first week of summer break came to a close, I was scrolling through the Roblox website, looking for new games to play. I should have been in bed. It was 9:52 p.m. when I noticed a new game had appeared on the popular page. There was no picture and the title simply read, Town of. Surely, the title must have been too long to fit in such a small space, so I tapped on it out of curiosity. The game was created by a user called B_B727. Oddly enough, the title was no more than Town of. Town of, what? I quickly clamped my hands over my mouth, coming to the realization that my parents could still be asleep. I paused a moment to make sure there was no response to the noise I just made, and quickly went back to studying the screen. I scrolled down to see the description, and it simply read, Population. Nothing, there were no numbers indicating how many people lived in this strange town. Weird, I thought, and at least 3,070 people are playing it, or maybe they are just bots. I shrugged absent-mindedly and tapped the play button. It was probably one of the greatest mistakes I made, now that I think about it. Upon joining, I was met with distorted music, almost like some weathered radio signal. I immediately shut off the volume to avoid waking anybody up. That's when I really wished I had earphones, but my mother also confiscated those for some weird reason. I schemed around the perimeter using a third-person view. The skybox was cloudy and red, resembling magma almost. Random blocks and other bits were scattered around the area, but there were no buildings to be seen in the practically desolate, green landscape. Where was the town? As I continued to explore my surroundings, I began to feel even more unsettled. The fact that bots would be on here was a mystery to me. Usually, the creators of games like these had something for sale, maybe admin commands, or a sweet item of some sort. This game had nothing like that. No signs of anything special advertising a cool trinket at the cost of some Robux. Maybe this was just some sort of publicity stunt, the creator of the game probably just wants people to check out his creation. Though it seemed like a lame idea, seeing as you could literally do nothing but walk around until your ears bled from the horrific sounds that played non-stop. Did you know that if you stay in a place out of your comfort for way too long, you start hearing and seeing things that aren't really there? That's what I'm told, at least, and I almost believe it after what transpired during my time on the game. I began hearing hysterical crying embedded within the white noise. It sounded like a full-grown man, much to my freaky realization. That wasn't the only thing I heard, however. Incoherent whispers filled the air, and I absolutely swear I could hear my username being spoken every few seconds. I honestly don't know why I refused to leave the game right then and there. By then it was 10:30, and I felt like I was going to wet myself. Nevertheless, I persisted in my exploration. And before long, a few other players joined. I guess I wasn't the only one curious as to why the game existed. I tried communicating with them, but they simply ignored me. Usernames were disabled, so I wasn't able to tell who they were by looking at them. But I was relieved. The last thing I wanted to do was play alone. The feeling of relief didn't last long, however, as they left shortly after. I was done with this game. I couldn't believe that I had wasted my time. I exited the game and went on to find something else to do. Somewhere around 10:50, I received a friend request. Like many friend requests, I would decline them. But this one was different. The second I saw who it was from, a chill whizzed down my spine. The friend request was sent by B_B727. His avatar was of a classic PAL hair character, except with green skin. The creator of that godforsaken game. Despite my sudden fear, I was in no mood to miss such a case-closing experience. And so, I clicked accept. I immediately received a message upon befriending the mysterious user. The message contained two words: come back. A sense of paranoia welled in my stomach. I mustered up the courage to respond, despite not knowing how to do so. Hello? I typed reluctantly.
Why did you leave?
B_B727 responded. Nothing was happening, I admitted. I got bored.
That's a shame.
B_B727 replied. Though his voice was a complete mystery, I could almost sense the eerie monotone voice he spoke with through every word he typed. You know, you could get banned for that, I said, reminiscing on the fact that shoving your own game into the popular section of the site through a horde of bots was against the rules.
What do you mean?
B_B727 asked. Oh, you know, making your game end up on the popular page by getting bots to join. It's not really fair to aspiring creators that actually take the time to make a quality game. Do you know what I'm saying?
The townspeople aren't bots.
B_B727 exclaimed.
They are real people, like you and me. I've never been so offended in my entire career.
What the hell are you talking about? I inquired, deeply annoyed.
Don't you know how lucky you are? For every user who plays on this damned website, my game only appears for them once. Once, I tell you. And they either ignore it, or they take the time to join.
I paused for a moment, considering what the mysterious user just said. I went back to the game's page and scrolled down to see it was created in 2010, and already had over 10,000 visits. I clicked on the server lists and to my horror, I saw a variety of different players. All of the different shapes and sizes, colors and personalities. There was no way these could be bots. I went back to the chat and confronted B_B727 once again. How did you get all these people to join your game? Did you send bots to hack these accounts? How did you do all this? I was honestly afraid. When I really thought about it, the game resembled a free Robux obby. When you get to the end, they ask you for your username and password. If you were dumb enough to give the game this information, a bot would sign into your account and begin spamming links to the same game. Only, in the case of this creepy game, it already knows your password, and you just have to be dumb enough to click on it. Who knew how many ads and links were being broadcasted now? This was probably the biggest raid ever on the history of Roblox, and I was speaking to the seed who planted it all. Only, this wasn't what I thought it was. The truth was much, much worse.
The question you should be asking isn't how, it's why.
A lump formed in my throat. I couldn't take any more of this. I left the chat, deleted the mysterious user from my friend list, and finally shut off my phone, shoving it between two pillows, followed by slipping into my bedsheets. Despite all that happened, I got to sleep easily. It was no beauty rest, however. I was confronted by nightmares of all sorts, hellish glimpses of the game I planned on never returning to, dismembered and mutilated corpses of my friend's Roblox avatars, and worst of all, the face of B_B727, only more horrific. A gelatinous, black liquid oozed from his unnaturally large eye ducts and his gaping mouth bared jagged teeth with bits of rotting flesh. It is amazing how the mind can enhance your greatest fears. They can turn spiders into giant arachnids, they can turn clowns into malicious serial killers. Also, they can turn a simple Roblox avatar into a nightmarish entity. I couldn't help but wonder if I should have done anything. If this was some widespread attack on one of the biggest online games, couldn't there have been a way to warn the ever-growing community about it? What I was most confused about was about the many individuals whose accounts supposedly got hacked. Why hadn't they said anything? There were thousands of them playing at the time, surely most of them found out about what was going on. All these thoughts manifested themselves into one massive headache, which soon sent me into a deep sleep. Upon waking up, I immediately grabbed my phone and logged back into Roblox. I wanted to know everything was okay, that everything I had experienced was just a dream. Everything looked normal. I searched up the game to see if it was still there. It took me a while to find it, but I did. Much to my relief, the game was under review. But the weird thing was that the server list was still filled with players. Had the Roblox Corporation not noticed this? I went to B_B727's user page, but it leads me to the 404 message. I tried to get access over and over, but the same error message kept popping up. Was he banned or not? Oh well, I thought, as long as he can't bother me. That's when I noticed something off. I don't know why I didn't see it beforehand. On the top right side of my screen, my notification box was jam-packed with several friend requests. Hundreds of them. I scrolled through a few pages, wondering why I was so popular all of a sudden. Could it have something to do with the fact that B_B727 was one of my friends at one point? Could all these users have known about him? I examined the top friend request and clicked the accept button. Right on cue, I received a message. How long was this guy waiting on me to notice him? I laughed. But my laughter was cut short when I read what was sent to me. Come back. My blood ran cold. I could hardly process what I just read. Come back? Does that mean what I think it means? I quickly exited the chat box and removed a creepy user from my friends list. Upon clicking on another page, I noticed I had even more friend requests. I shuddered. I accepted at least 10 of them, and upon doing so, I received the same message. Come. Back. This can't be happening, I screamed in my head. Were these really the residents of B_B727's mysterious town? They had to be bots. It was the only plausible explanation for all this. Enough was enough. B_B727 wasn't going to stop me from enjoying one of my most favorite games. I logged out of my account and made a brand new one. Now, you may be thinking, why abandon your account that you spent so many months on, working your way to the top on so many games? What about all that progress? Just understand that if you were in the horrific situation I was in, you would at least consider it. Of course, making another account was just another door to more terrors. Once I gained access to my profile page, I saw something that shouldn't have been there. It was a game. And it was on my favorites page. This unnatural sighting almost made me vomit. I never thought I would see that godforsaken game again. I'm sure you know which one I'm talking about. I felt like I was going to go insane. I stared at the entrance of the game's page for what seemed like hours. If they wanted me to join so bad, I might as well yield. I wanted nothing more from them but to leave me alone so I can enjoy myself. At this point, I had two options. 1. Abandon Roblox completely. 2. Become a resident of the town of, however that works. I chose option 2. Well, not yet. It couldn't be that bad, right? I reluctantly clicked on the page and was brought face to face with a picture that hadn't been there before. It was out in plain fields with the familiar hellish skybox and ruins of buildings made from white bricks. I couldn't believe I didn't realize what those were meant for before. Still, this odd discovery failed to make me feel any better. B_B727's avatar was standing in the center, and surrounding him were hundreds of other players, all different shapes, sizes, and accessories. All of them were staring directly at me. I couldn't help but believe that every one of them was a normal player like me but brainwashed to live a lifestyle they couldn't ever get out of. That's what I theorized, at least. If this was some sort of prank, it would have stopped by now. They already made their point clear. The chances of me giving up were pretty high, so they would have stopped when I was on my original account. I know in the beginning I said the game has been removed. But still, who knows how many victims it claimed. And I could be its next one. I'm not sure what fate I might face. Maybe my computer will get hacked and my IP will be revealed. I honestly don't know. As I write this, I still have the tab up and the play button jar. The mystery can be solved with a click of the button. I'm just afraid of what will happen. Despite it has been removed, that doesn't mean it won't appear for any of you. I'm afraid I can't tell you what to do if it does. No matter how hard I try, I can't get rid of it. As said by many, curiosity killed the cat. That's kind of the situation I'm in right now. You may be dying to know what's going, and despite my fear, I'm going to find out. Plus, I may not have a choice. Because just the other day, my mother received an email on her phone. She was awfully confused by its context, so she showed it to me. And it read,
"Are you coming home yet?"
The message was from an email user called B_B727.